Hello, everybody. Welcome back. I'm Daikon Dave from Food Literacy Center, and I'm here today to talk to you about fat. But before we talk about fat, I'm going to recap what Mushroom Meyer was telling us last week about sugar. She was talking to us about sugar and how there are long-lasting sugars that give you energy all day long, like the fabulous oatmeal we made, and there's actually fast-acting sugar, like our sugary cereals and candies and stuff, that will skyrocket our energy and then drop us back down if that's happened to anyone else. So that oatmeal looked totally delicious, gave us fiber that helps like be a broom that sweeps our bodies out and keeps us clean. So today we are talking about fat. Let's see. Let me get a show of hands. How many people think our bodies need fat? All right. How many people think our bodies don't need fat? Well, actually, believe it or not, our bodies do need fat. What our bodies use fat for is stored energy, right? We got a little stored energy that after our bodies use that sugar that Meyer was talking about for energy. Our bodies use our fat for stored energy, and actually our brains, guess what our brains are made out of? Mostly. Did you guess fat? You're right. Our brains are mostly made out of fat, and our brains use fat to help us think. So with that, we are going to talk about the two different places that fat come from. There are two different fats. Can you give me a guess on the two places fat come from? The first one's obviously probably animal fat. So that's going to be our chicken, our beef, dairy, cheeses, eggs, things like that. And do you believe that we can get fat from plants? Well, you can if you were following that activity we had earlier. Eggplant Evelyn was showing us that fat comes from plants and animals. So we can get fats from plants from nuts and seeds. We could get them from olive oils and vegetable oils. And another great source of fat is an avocado, right? The avocado. So our recipe we're going to make today is guacamole. Guacamole using this fat, plant fat source, the avocado. So if you all have your recipes with you, I have mine with me right here. We're gonna follow along with the recipe. So we're gonna start with the ingredients. Now, why do you think you should read all the ingredients before you start the recipe? To probably make sure that we have all the things that we need, right, before we start. So why don't you at home help me point out all the ingredients to the recipe to make sure we have it all. So the first one is one avocado. Could everyone point to the avocado? Right, so we have an avocado here. Second one is 1 tablespoon of chopped cilantro. Do you have cilantro? Can you guys point to the cilantro? All right, we got some cilantro right here. Love the cilantro. All right, 2 teaspoons of green onion. Do you all have green onions at home? Right, we got green onion right here. Lime or lemon. We could use limes or lemons, whatever you got. And we got limes right here, right? So we got a lime to juice right here. And salt and pepper to taste. That's what you guys have at home for salt and pepper to taste. So why don't we start making guacamole? What do you guys say? It's almost getting to lunchtime, and just reading the recipe is making me hungry, so why don't we start? So the first instruction is probably for the adults to start, and the kids could help. So you take your avocado, and you want to cut it in half and remove the seed. So I'm going to try and do that with our kid's knife here. So what we're going to do, there's a pit in the middle, and you want to be careful if you're using a sharp knife, right? So we're going to cut through the avocado like this till it hits the pit, and we can wheel the avocado around the knife like this to help keep you from cutting and split it open like that. Now, one tip I have for taking the pit out for the adults is we can pierce it. I'm going to try it with an adult knife. If you pierce the seed, with your knife like this, and you can just give it a twist and it comes back out. Now, what do you do when that's stuck on your knife, dude? You don't want to cut yourself, right? What I do is you could just pinch either side of the seed on the blade and it falls right out like that. Your fingers don't get anywhere near the blade. So we have that. We have the avocado split in half. And now we're on to the kids. So now the kids that we have our avocado split in half, we want to use a spoon and scoop that into our bowl. So we have our bowl right here. We're gonna take the avocado and just run your spoon between the flesh and the skin right here and just scoop it out into our bowl. Make sure to get all that yummy avocado in there. Excuse me. With both halves, right? Run the spoon along the skin and the flesh and just scoop it out in scoops. We get it all out of there, right? So there's that. Now what are we supposed to do? Use a fork and mash the avocado into a creamy but chunky consistency. And this is the fun part right here. So we take the fork and we're gonna just mash it up. Mash it up, I don't know if you can see that. Mash it up till it's creamy. We can take turns and count too as well. Count maybe to five. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five, maybe six, seven, eight, nine, ten. All right. Now we got it pretty creamy and we got some chunks in there. All right. Now what are we going to add to our avocados? Excuse me. Okay. So we need to chop up our cilantro. What, we don't even really need to chop it. We could just pull the leaves off and break it into our avocado, into our guacamole like that. We could use the seed. If you want the stems, you might want to chop the stems. Chop some stems up in there and some seeds by using our claw. That's not really working too well. So we are going to use the leaves. We could just break those off and break them in there. Oh, maybe even give it a smell. That smells so good. Cilantro smells so good. We're going to put that in there. Dice our green onion. Here's one tip for the green onion. If you have it with the roots on the end, you could chop it up to the white and stick it in a glass of water and it'll continue to grow. Just a little tip out there. So we are going to use our claw and cut these into little pieces. I don't know if you can see. Here, right? Run it in there. Little pieces as possible with our claw. Because we don't want a big mouthful of green onion. We just want it to have the flavor, right? So we're going to put 2 teaspoons. So I do have a measuring spoon here. The teaspoon is this one right here. Teaspoon. And we could actually measure that in there if you want. You like a little more green onion? You like a little less green onion? We can, but you can measure. We're measuring today because we're showing you the recipe, right? So we are measuring our green onion there. And now limes. Oh, limes are my favorite. So we're gonna juice a lime and I'm gonna run it on my cutting board like this and kind of get it soft. Get it soft, okay? And with our tunnel, we all remember our tunnel. We're gonna cut the lime in half. Flat side down on the board, we're gonna cut it in half again. And we're gonna use 2 ledges, the juice of 2 lemon wedges or lime wedges, whatever you had at home. So we're gonna squeeze that in there like that. If you like a little more, you like a little less, and squeeze it in there like that. And now we're gonna take our fork back and mix it all up. Mix it all up. And there we have our guacamole. And you guys ready to taste? What I have today to taste, I cut up a jicama. Can y'all say jicama? That's kind of fun to say, right? Jicama, if you haven't had it before, I chopped this in half and you want to take the skin off. Take the skin off, it's super tough. It's a way to have a fruit or vegetable with every snack and meal. And it was described to me from a kid as kind of if an apple and a potato crossed, it kind of tastes like jicama. It's got a sweet, starchy taste. And maybe you guys want to be food adventurers and try that if you don't have jicama. I'd slice some carrot, kind of diagonally, so it looks like a chip. So you ready to try? Let's give it a try. Super yummy, and the lime just hits it. The line is perfect on there. And thank you for joining us today. I'm gonna eat this guacamole for lunch. You could go to our website, foodliteracycenter.org, and hit curriculum to see past curriculum or our future curriculum. This week we are doing noodle soup, and I will see you then. Thank you so much for sharing time with us today, and we will see you soon. Thank you. Thank you.